Ladies and gentlemen, it's Zeus Alan Souter. And ladies and gentlemen, the reigning two-time champion of the world, State Mind, Peter Ray.
Clash of the Scotsman and a clash of who's got the loudest trousers on in this Group E tie. Peter Wright, I suppose, not looking his usual self. Hasn't got his hair done tonight. His wife Jo has been in hospital. She's had surgery and back in hospital last night, actually, and she looks after his hair. So we sent our best wishes to Jo and wishing her a speedy recovery. I think that was a bit of a message there from Peter Wright as well at the camera when he walked onto the stage for Jo. But the reigning world champion. Look, they're friends. Two Scotsmen together. Not going to be friends in a minute, though, are they? No. Opponents tonight. The reigning world champion, then. Not breathtaking last night against Fallon Sherrick. Despite a 5-1 scoreline, averaged below 87 in that win. Alan Souter, meanwhile, in his first appearance on the Grand Slam stage, beat Nathan Aspinall in a last-leg decider in some style as well. In five previous meetings since February 2021. You know what? It's Alan Souter 3, Peter Wright 2. So how will this meeting go? To guide you through it, here's Laura Turner and Mark Webster.
Yes, thank you, Emma. Penultimate match of the second day here at the Grand Slam of Darts. And it's a Scottish affair, like Emma said. Could be a future World Cup team in the future. Who knows? But we see Alan Souter, that 5-4 win with that 1-4-5 finish means he's won his last six deciding legs he's played in all events. That shows he's got the bottle when it comes to the back end of a match, a close match. But this is a big challenge again. Peter Wright underperformed last night. I don't see it happening again, Laura. I think Souter will have to play better, but giving himself a great chance either way. It was impressive against Nathan Aspinall. He's going to have to be equally impressive if he's going to get by Peter Wright here.
Yeah, I totally agree with you. But the one thing I said in the Aspinall match, and I'll say again, is Alan Souter doesn't ever really know when to give up. He's a real fighter. He digs in and he does get results.
Well, the evidence in the World Championship last year, wasn't it? He beat Yoga Potato in the opening round. Then he was trailing Mensa Sulevic. Survived match starts, got through. Same against Jose de Souza the round after. Once he succumbed to Callum Ridds. But it's when people sort of stood up and took notice of Alan Souter. And it's been a year of just maintaining it. He said this interview today, hasn't really progressed, but it's down to his work schedule. He's not fully committed to, I say fully committed, he can't sort of practice the hours he'd like because of his job in the fire service. But again, he's qualified for the World Championship, so it's still progress for Alan Souter. But the scalp of Peter Wright on a big stage, what would that do for the Alan Souter profile?
Loose second dart there from Peter Wright, but corrected himself.
Stay down there, Souter. Aim to leave 170 or better. Ah, really good last dart. Just shuffled across to the left, open at the bed, and has a chance of breaking the Peter Wright throw early here.
Good switch there from Peter Wright, but chance here for Alan Souter.
Yeah, stay there. Well, he attempted to stay there. It was inviting. Generally, if the ball had been lowered, he'd have probably looked at treble 14, but like I said, plenty of space, just the execution not there. But a good side here. Peter Wright, decision to make here. Is it straightforward or a split?
Yeah, straight for it and straight in it. First leg to Peter Wright.
Yeah, staying in the 10, aggression straight up the double 19. Hold a throw for Snakebite in the opening leg here.
100.
Bit of a shake of the head. I think he's disappointed he didn't find that second ball. He gave himself a great opportunity, didn't he? And just didn't follow in, but so we hold a throw for Peter Wright. Alan Souter knows there's time in this match. He needs a break at some point.
400.
I was saying yesterday, Alan Souter, after he won his match, you know, he's been tinkering with his setup as well. He's changed, I think he said 30 odd years, he's been playing a pear shaped flight, so working with a sponsor to kind of change a setup. And he really said he's feeling the difference.
Yeah, he said he's had a bit of a flat year, but since he's made that change, like you said, Laurie, he's felt a difference. And obviously, getting through the qualifiers to get here takes some doing. Beating Nathan Aspinall as well. Just had a glimpse of the table there. It's pretty bleak for Fallon Sherrick, but it's 2 from 3.
100.
Nathan Aspinall spoke to after this game with Fallon Sherrick. He wants to keep it simple. He wants Souter to win. Then he just goes head-to-head with Peter Wright.
Peter Wright just having a quick look there. Yeah, does register the first 180 of the match.
Yeah, and there's a chance here for Peter Wright to break throw. Ah, good adjustment.
100.
He's had a hard time. It's okay, Alan Souter, but Peter Wright knows on treble need, he's got it. Just got to stay in that 11 segment. Just about. Double 14, he's double checking, but this for the breaker throw. Yeah, it's right in the corner. 28. And Souter will be looking away, but he'll be looking to the ground now, because that is a breaker throw. Acknowledged by Alan Souter, but Peter Wright, who didn't even need a break, opens up a two-leg lead, and it is so much better than yesterday. Averaged 86 in his match against Fallon Sherrick. He stuck 20 points plus on that already. A bright start from Peter Wright. Wayne Mardle said he'd play better, and Wolves was right.
Even a broken clock is right two times a day.
He's got to maintain it now, hasn't he, Peter Wright?
58.
Yeah, as you kind of mentioned previously with Alan Souter, he seems to bring out his best game when he's trailing.
Yeah, don't write him off. He'll keep chipping away. But it just looks a lot more controlled from Peter today. He was edgy throughout that game with Fallon Sherrick, but he got the job done. Incidentally, this group matches up with Johnny Clayton, Damon Hetter, Leonard Gates, Jermaine Watermain, and we know Johnny Clayton's through from that group, likely to finish top, so I mean the runner-up would play from this group would play Johnny, but still plenty more games to go. This group concludes on Tuesday evening.
60.
So I hit 1-3-3 earlier to leave that 1-3-2. Looking for it again. Unlucky.
95.
Yeah, great last start there from Peter Wright. Leaves the same 1-3-2 that we saw Alan Souter leave earlier.
Obviously going to get a go at it, but what pressure is going to be under? Yeah, that's not enough for me. Peter Wright, in all likelihood, will have six at this 1-3-2 if he needs him. 57 for the ball.
64. Alan,
it's Alan Souter, 1-4-8 to get the break back. Inviting. Oh, here we go. He had a 1-4-5 to win yesterday and oh, pulls it inside. He's had chances, Alan Souter.
So 16 for 32 for a 3-0 lead.
Peter Wright misses first dart at a double in the match. Awkward double, double seven, you can see. I still see plenty of it though. Big dart for Suter. Ah, brilliant dart right in the corner. And that's the break back, and credit to him. He's been giving himself a bit of a hard time at the back of the legs, Alan Suter, but he deserved that. Half the deficit, and we're back on throw.
Yeah, and that visit there from Suter just really opens the door for Peter Wright.
Good last one. I said earlier, the final fixtures in this group Tuesday evening. Peter Wright will take on Nathan Aspinall. Alan Suter will take on Fallon Sherrick. Alan Suter, if he wins, is guaranteed a place in the last 16. If he beats Peter Wright here, that is. 97. Van Gerwen confirming his spot in the last 16 as well, winning five straight legs against Luke Woodhouse in our previous match. And the final match of the evening, oh, we could have saved the best to last. Luke Humphreys versus Ryan Searling, that tight Group H. That wraps up day two here in Wolverhampton.
140.
Second 140, the match for Alan Suter. See Peter looking a bit perplexed.
He started brightly and he's tailing off here. And it's encouraging Alan Suter. Ah, brilliant setup. Really good from Suits. 12 darts thrown, 36. Should level up this match.
So for an even game, 36 required for Alan Suter. Absolutely pins it.
Really good response from going two legs down, Alan Suter. Legs of his own. And there we see decent finishing stats. Made a good point, Laurie. He digs in deep. He won't shy away from a last leg shootout. The stats earlier illustrated that. He's playing better than the current world champion. Three times a runner-up here, Peter Wright. Runner-up last year, just ran out of steam in that final against Gedwin Price.
Yeah, this is Peter Wright's 10th appearance and only failed to get past the round robin stages on two occasions, one of them being his debut.
And one was 2 years ago, so if he can have a run here, he's in a bit of profit, isn't he? So. To do in this game and this group. And there's the evidence, the leg-by-leg averages, he's just tailed off in the last two legs, Peter Wright. After such a bright start.
60.
Yeah, in that match against Fallon Sherrick last night, I think Peter Wright did open up with a 13 dart leg. He did have a very impressive first one, and then obviously, as we've mentioned before, just it got a bit scrappy, he tailed off. So hopefully that's not a sign of things to come, but yeah, just not finding it as much.
It is a nervy stage, the group stage. You just want to get it done with, get through, and then players settle then. A longer format, first to 10 in the last 16, then it goes first to 16. It gets really stretched out then, but these are nervy games, best of nine, and doesn't take long to get the game won, but it doesn't take long for it to slip from your grasp even. And Peter Wright, got to be careful. Led 2-0, remember. Could lead again here with double 12. Pulls it inside. Same route you feel for Alan Suter.
You can see that trademark from Alan Suter where he's just trying to G himself up before every throw. Wandered into the five, but it's not lost.
They weren't convincing darts, but he'd be disappointed with Alan Suter.
45, PD required 12.
Right for 3-2. Yeah, good dart. And moves back in front. stops the mini surge from Alan Suter, and is two legs away from doubling his points tally. Two wins from two. The final match of the evening, Luke Humphries v Ryan Searle to follow this. Win for Searle, and he's into the knockout stages for the first time.
64.
Suter, that was a win here, would put him into the knockout on debut here at the Grand Slam.
100.
Suter made a steady start to this sixth leg. Just not able to find that treble.
54.
Playing well, Alan Suter. Averaging over 96. Don't fancy this.
140.
Shows a lot of emotion, Alan Suter. An emotional player, passionate player.
100, and you require 160.
Confirmed his place in the World Championships again. Peter Wright gets his campaign underway on night one, defending champion. Sensible play from Suter here. Yeah, I like that.
125.
And you see with certain players, won't you, they just want to take the check out, they just want to go for it, but
93.
When you're embroiled in a match and it's only a race to five, play sensible.
Yeah, I agree. And if you know, you start splitting 25, you go over to the nine, you miss the big number, then it gets messy. Alan Suter did the right thing, as it's proved there. Pins the 36. We're level again. Two more legs. Alan Suter's in the last 16, but will have to break the world champion's throw.
140.
Response there from Alan Suter. First 180 of the match for him.
He fancies it, doesn't he? Why wouldn't he? But this is why he's the world champion. Not playing at his best, but still digging in. A ton separates the pair. A key leg. Possibility of nine dart gone, but anguish for Suter.
Yeah, like we've said on so many occasions, you know, champions do tend to find a way. Even if they're not quite where we'd always expect them
65.
To be.
Big score here for Suter. Breaks here and holds. He'll be top of the table with 4 points with a big Q next to his name. Got to finish the job, and he's played well, Laura, hasn't he? Really well, Alan Suter. He's given everything to this match, and he's going to get a chance here. That's a big last dart.
Good last dart there, and for Alan Suter, just a shade over 100 in terms of the average. Needs a treble, and that just shows how important that last dart was from Peter Wright.
That's disappointing, because you always fancy yourself to get that dart. You expect that dart, the ball, the way he's playing. And he's worked hard, Alan Suter, in this leg, but may not even get a chance. 4-3, Peter Wright, if he hits this top, it's over to tens. Wow, now then.
36, and you require 72.
What an opportunity for Alan Suter. Gets it, and there we see the emotion from Alan Suter. He deserves it. He leads 4-3 against the world champion, and he will now throw for the match, and it would confirm a place in the last 16 for Alan Suter, and it would leave Peter Wright. The winner takes all match with Nathan Aspinall on Tuesday evening. Got to hold himself together here now, Alan Suter.
There's that trademark grimace again. When you're throwing for the match and it's your darts, you want to you want to be hitting that treble 20.
You just want to see it, that sort of first dart, don't you? What Peter Wright got with his second dart there. But yeah, there's the group as it stands. But one more leg in this match for Suter. He's confirmed through, but he needs to find a treble. Good dart. And he's willing the next one in. Oh, that's unlucky.
Just clattered into the dart that was already in the treble 20.
81.
Not massive damage done. What can Suter do here? Ah, really good switch. You could see there wasn't much room in that treble 20. Deserves this chance, Alan Suter.
40.
And he's got breathing space. He's in dreamland here.
Yeah, it's been a real turnaround, a game of two halves. Peter Wright just kicking off really, really strongly and he's just fizzled
96.
Out. He averaged 86 last night. He's averaging 89 and a half. His torn average, 88 after two matches. And he's got six at 1-3-2 here. Doesn't need this ball, Alan Suter. He'll start at the top of the board and pretty soon. Finished on 1-4-5 yesterday. Can he squeeze one through? Brilliant dart, because that would have still made it delicate. But he's going to have three match darts for a place in the last 16 with a game to spare.
140.
There's the pressure, but it's out of Peter Wright's hands. For the match. Another one. Stay focused. Oh, wow.
No score.
I'm not sure what happened with that. That last one's really caught the flight, but what an opportunity. Smiling, but deep down, he is raging, Alan Suter. Will he get a reprieve?
Wright needs double 10 and pins double 10.
Alan Suter has had three match darts to win. Not just win, put a place in the last 16. He's got to find a break of throw all over again now. He can't believe it. Can he go again?
57.
Peter Wright has left the door open for him here. That was high. That was nervy.
Yeah, he's
60.
He's just got to refocus. It is hard when you mismatch darts. Alan Suter, yeah, he's still, you can see.
81.
Wouldn't make a poker player, would he?
No.
Gives everything away up there, but he gives it everything as well. That's better. Look at the grimace. Brilliant from Alan Suter. Third match of the match, 2-2 Alan. And is he going to get himself more opportunities? And is Peter Wright going to fire back? Can't quite fire back, but it's a decent response.
Now what can Alan Suter set up? Great first dart, great second dart.
Look at the aggression.
140.
Well, you've missed three match darts and you realise you've got to break the world champion's throw again and you're on 1-2-1 after nine darts. You take that. But Peter Wright is asking questions.
And you've got 121.
Opportunity again for Alan Suter. Seen a 1-2-1 in the match already for Peter Wright. Treble 17 for the ball. Bullseye, a fourth match dart. Oh, he's done the right thing if it wasn't gripped properly, but the only thing is it does bring the crowd in, but a dart at ball. For the match and a spot in the last 16. And it's gone begging. Four match darts for Alan Suter have come and gone.
He required 102.
There's an argument to stay on treble 20 there.
86.
More match starts coming. 24. Four already. You hope it's fifth time. Suter to win. And it's 17. Six darts for the match. And he can't convert. Peter Wright's got away with one here.
16.
Is he going to make Suter pay? Eight match darts in total have come and gone. Six for Suter, two for Peter Wright. But he only needs one more. It's heartbreak for Alan Suter. He's still got a great chance of making the last 16, but it should be done and dusted. He's had six darts to win. Unfortunately, he goes again. He's back on Tuesday evening. He will take on Fallon Sherrett. Peter Wright acknowledging the efforts of Alan Suter, but it's Peter Wright, the world champion, who wins by 5 legs to 4. He's got 1 foot